spirit to her, and it took on for her the form of a handsome, well-built man. Not knowing that it was Jibril, she sought refuge with God and told him that she held God in the utmost fear and respect. She said, "I seek refuge from you with the All-Merciful. Leave me if you fear God." Her words clearly demonstrate her complete trust in God, as well as the importance she placed upon chastity and devotion to God. Jibril revealed that he was a messenger of God's, and that he had come to her with glad tidings from him. When the angels said, "Maryam, your Lord gives you good news of a word from him. His name is the Messiah, Isa, son of Maryam, of high esteem in this world and the hereafter, and one of those brought near." Maryam asked Jibril how she could have a child when no man had ever touched her. "My Lord, how can I have a son when no man has ever touched me?" He said, "It will be so. God creates whatever he wills. When he decides on something, he just says to it, 'Be,' and it is." By the will of God, Maryam became pregnant with Isa, although no man had ever touched her. Her pregnancy was independent of this world's usual cause and effect relationship. The circumstances of his conception were among the features of Isa's miracle. He said, "It will be so. Your Lord says, 'That is easy for me. It is so that we can make him a sign for humanity and a mercy from us. It is a matter already decreed.' So she conceived him and withdrew with him to a distant place." After she had conceived, at God's will, Maryam withdrew to an isolated place. There is, without a doubt, great wisdom in Maryam spending her pregnancy in an isolated spot. One element of this is that in this way, God kept her away from the disturbing behavior of people who would be unable to understand this miraculous state of affairs. God fully supported Maryam throughout her pregnancy. It is very difficult for a woman to give birth, a potentially life-threatening experience, all alone, without medical equipment or a midwife's assistance. Nevertheless, Maryam overcame all of these difficulties by placing her complete trust in God. He helped her with revelations while she was struggling towards a date tree in the full throes of labor. The pains of labor drove her to the trunk of a date palm. She exclaimed, "Oh, if only I had died before this time, and was something discarded and forgotten." A voice called out to her from under her, "Do not grieve. Your Lord has placed a small stream at your feet. Shake the trunk of the palm toward you, and fresh, ripe dates will drop down to you. Eat and drink and delight your eyes." There is also great wisdom in the way that God tells Maryam not to grieve and to eat dates, and that he had created a small stream for her. There are indications of various methods of facilitating birth in all these verses. God commanded Maryam not to grieve, but to keep her spirits up. Modern medicine has shown that it is most important for mother and baby, for a pregnant woman, or one about to give birth, to avoid stress and to maintain a positive state of mind. In the same verses, it is reported that God commanded Maryam, who was suffering from labor pains, to shake a date branch towards her. Doctors say that pulling something toward oneself during labor can have a positive effect on the muscles. In order to ease labor pains and help bring about a safe delivery, women are advised to do certain exercises that reduce pressure in the body and, therefore, the risk of complications during delivery. They are also thought to quicken the process of giving birth. Another thing emphasized in the verses is dates. Today, such dates are considered to be a food and medicine. Scientists now know that dates contain more than 10 substances considered essential for the human body's well-being and continued good health. Scientists now inform us that people can survive on dates and water for years, because they contain all of the necessary essentials for human life. Dates provide energy, help muscle tissues and nerve cells develop, and are especially beneficial for people weakened by illness or those suffering from exhaustion because of their high calorific value. Modern medical findings suggest that dates benefit women who are almost ready to give birth. Doctors now advise pregnant women to take fructose-containing foods on their due dates, for such foods provide energy used by the weakened body to revitalize itself. The substance known as oxytocin, which is found in dates, is used as a drug to make giving birth easier. Oxytocin is used in modern medicine to accelerate labor and is often referred to as rapid birth. It also increases the level of milk production following birth. We may list a few of the benefits from the vitamins and minerals in dates for the normal human body and during pregnancy, thus. They contain folic acid, an essential vitamin for pregnant women. It meets the body's need for potassium, caused by physical reactions and long-term nausea during pregnancy. It meets the body's increased need for vitamin A during pregnancy. Most fruits are poor in protein, but the protein in dates helps protect the body against disease and infections. The iron in dates prevents anemia during pregnancy. All of our current information on dates reveals God's infinite wisdom and grace upon Maryam, who, inspired by God, might have satisfied all her nutritional needs by eating dates and thereby easing her child's birth.